Actually, I was told to take a lecture on cardiology. And Dr. Devon called me. As a lecturer, I always like to teach my students. When I was in St. G.S. Medical College as a lecturer for chest disease. And this is my most liking subject. What knowledge you get, you must share with everyone. And today, homeopathy is lacking behind because knowledge is not shared properly. And ambiguity, no clear the directions, no one knows what potency to use, how to select, how to equalize, and all of this ambiguity has come because those who have understood real ambiguity, they were elected to share so that the success will be theirs. You know, I'll let tell you in short that after starting my 16-bedded nursing home with 4-bedded ICU, I was forced to do temporary heart transplantation at Jalgaon. That was not possible in Khandesh area. By doing all this bigger job, my mother fell sick. And that time I took her to Bombay and we saw that it was a big cardiomyopathy with ischemic heart disease. Dr. Ashwin Mehta was my teacher, best cardiologist in India. And nothing could be done. I said, sir, we have got so much of knowledge, science is so advanced. My mother cannot be saved. What's the use of becoming a doctor if I can't save my mother? He said, you are becoming emotional. This is there, what we can offer, and nothing can be done in the world now. I said, okay, I can't talk anything more. But I was very sad, nervous. And I was always feeling that something is lacking, why can't we save? And one of my friends, he said, do you believe in homeopathy? I said, I believe in homeopathy, but not so much. Because one past experience while doing my MD, the stocks I cured my PID, which I was to be in bed for 6 weeks, I was cured in one day's time. So, but whether it will do in heart disease, doubtful. Is there any other thing you are trying? I said, no. Then let us start. Started with that. He started giving very religiously, being a doctor, he was attending also properly. But you know, gradually the situations became worse. She was going to failure. Then she developed tuberculosis. He said, no, we are not giving any allopathic drugs. I said, I respect you because now I have handed over the case. And the case was deteriorating. And why I am telling you this? Because it's very important in our practice when we face such. And that is where homeopathy gets criticism. As a chest specialist, my mother suffering from cardiomyopathy and tuberculosis of lungs. I was seeing the shadows getting worse. Cavitation is formed. I was telling him, clinically she is deteriorating. He said, no, it's an aggravation. I was not knowing much about homeopathy. I said, okay, aggravation. But it was a deterioration of the disease. You must know what is medical homeopathic medicine aggravation and what is disease deterioration. There is a demarcation between two. And it is always, many a times, missed. And we landed to problems. But he being a very famous homeopath, I had no choice. Inside I was feeling frustrated. Now what to do? Then at night when I saw, I said she will land into now a big emergency. So I shifted all my ICU equipment at home. I called my lab man. I had my own lab. You better keep 2 bottles of blood ready. In case there is some emergency, I should handle it. Morning 3 o'clock I got up. I was anticipating, but I had no choice. And 4 o'clock she vomited and a big hemoptysis of 1 liter. full flow of blood. And she collapsed, no pulse, no beating. Immediately, my assistant was sitting there, I was so nervous, I could get her away. So I said, you put away immediately and put a Himaxyl, which will improve the blood pressure. And then 2 bottles, blood transfusion was done. And luckily, she came up. But she went into multi-organ failure. Renal failure, hepatic failure, everything was lying. Potassium was 7.5. She was a diabetic, uncontrolled diabetes. With such an infection, secondary infection, septicemia. See how many problems were there. I said, my God, I landed from bad to worse. What to do? Ultimately, I contacted her. See, I told you that she has been deteriorating. I don't know how it happened. So I was telling you, I was guiding you. If you can't understand, take second opinion. Many times it happens, even at this stage, many times. I always feel to have a second opinion. And that is the biggest thing in allopathy. That there is a confidence, 10 doctors did come. The ego problem is not there. You may see from one angle, she may see from one angle, she may see from another angle. And that is how we come and arrive and discuss. By chance, if I misstart something, certain things are done. In such cases, group discussions, group approaches, and a proper approach is very important. You should not take it the ego, because when we are treating a patient, why we have become a doctor? We have become a doctor to cure patients. And not as a fanatic. See, every pathy, doctors are fanatics. I am all pathy doctor. But I have a great respect for homeopathy because I know. I have studied all alternative sciences. All 117 alternative sciences I have read books of which 20 I have practiced after this case. And therefore one should not be a fanatic. You should have a broad outlook. Every science has got good things and bad things. Allopaths, they have used homeopaths, homeopaths, they have used allopaths. This should not be there. We are born doctors. Some restrictions, obstructions, some not understanding the case. We must always take help of expert opinion, second opinion. Take the patient into confidence and tell them that I want this, this, this. If you have faith, you come back. If you are not fit, lost hope. But at least you are good at your heart. You don't get the bad things of what patient suffers. Then, coming to my mother's point, she was lying with multi-organ failure, septicemia. I was very much attached to my mother. I had left my Hinduja apartment. I would have been head of Hinduja chest department. I had gone back for her because she wanted to be there at this injury. I was very emotional about what to do. Desperately searching, at least ask some other homeopaths. Looking to her condition, everyone was afraid. She being my mother, no one was ready to come and do anything. But one of my very distant relatives,